Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand.
Hello, this is Campbell Rutherford, and today we are going to learn how to export a graph from Desmos to Word. So really quickly, we've got Desmos open right now. So let's graph a quick function. But let's do an insert to first to make sure that our character echo is turned off.
Words. Both characters and words. None.
There we go. So we have
quote y quote equals you need something on quote x quote superscript bit 2. Quote y quote equals quote x quote squared as graph to audio trace press alt plus t.
All right. So we don't need to audio trace this at the moment. Let's just go ahead and share this graph or export it. So we're going to shift tab to the share button menu.
Help button menu. Share button menu.
All right,
press
so
space to activate the menu, then navigate with arrow keys.
So let's hit spacebar.
Expanded. Complementary region. Link to this graph edit. HTTP.
All right, so we're going to tab to export graph link or export image.
Copy button. Print graph and equations link. Export image link.
Export image. Here we go. Let's press enter.
Desmos vertical bar graphing calculator.
And now there are a few ways to get to the button, the download PNG button. It's a bit strange. You can either use your JAWS form fields with insert F5 and press I, which will get you in the general area of the button, or you can just shift tab to it. So today, let's just shift tab to it so you can kind of see where the button is in relation to everything else.
Language button menu, help button, share, sign up link, login link, home, untitled, open graph selected, view site info, download, show all button to close button to activate, press space bar. Toolbar, view site information, but secure to active, downloads bar, close button to activate, press space, space, Desmos vertical, dialog, image download group, SVG options button, collapse.
So now
activate,
we're in the image
enter.
Download group, so we have SVG options,
download PNG
and download
button to
PNG
activate, press
buttons.
Enter.
So we'll press enter.
Enter, alert, alert, download complete, colon, Desmos, dash, graph, left, paren, one, right, paren, dot, PNG, press shift, plus F6 to cycle to.
And so we heard it say Desmos graph left paren one right paren, and that's important to note because we need to know the exact title of this graph. So now I'm going to alt tab to a Word document that I have open, and we're going to insert this graph into there.
Meeting control document one dash word.
So
document one dash word edit.
And now to insert the graph, I'm going to do alt N for insert and P for picture.
Alt N, upper ribbon, ribbon, ribbon tap E, menu, leaving menus, this device, dot, dot, dot,
yes,
to move
want,
through items, press up or down arrow, alt followed
device,
by N,
so let's
P,
press
D.
Enter.
Leaving menus, upper ribbon, ribbon, ribbon tabs, tab expanded, insert tab, alt plus N, leaving menus, leaving ribbons, insert picture dialog, file name, colon, edit combo, to set the value, use the arrow keys or type the value, alt plus N.
Okay, so right now it's in the file name, and so I want to jump to my address bar to make sure that we are in my downloads folder because that's where our picture is going to be. So let's do an Alt D to check that.
Alt D, address edit combo, C colon backslash users backslash Campbell Rutherford backslash downloads.
Okay.
To set the value, use the arrow keys or type the value.
And if it wasn't downloads, you could have just typed D-O-W and down arrowed to your downloads folder and pressed enter. So now that we know that it's in our downloads folder, let's press Alt N again to jump back to the file name.
Alt N, file name colon edit combo to set the value, use the arrow key.
All right, so I'm going to type DES for Desmos.
DES.
And I have a couple of Desmos graphs. So let's down arrow.
Desmos dash graph left paren one right paren dot PNG.
Okay, so we have the Desmos graph left paren one right paren, which if you'll remember is the one from the one that we just exported. So I'm going to press enter on this graph.
Selected picture two image 6.5 inches wide by 6.5 inches high in line with text. Oh. Document one,
okay.
Chart line chart description automatically generated graphic chart.
So
table in line with text button selected to move to an item.
Oops.
Press the arrow key escape.
Right.
Document
right.
one, document one, chart line chart description automatically generated graphic chart line chart
and
description automatically
let's
generated image.
But as you may have heard, the graph is 6.5 inches wide by 6.5 inches high, which is a pretty big graph, especially when you're considering that most average sheets of paper are 8.5 by 11 inches. So we want to make this smaller. So let's press our applications key, and then we're going to press Z for size and position.
Applications menu cut to move through items. Press up or down arrow. Z leaving menus cancel button to activate. Press space bar.
All right. So before we check our height and width, let's do an Alt A to check our lock aspect ratio. This means that when we adjust the height of our graph, the width will be adjusted automatically. So let's do Alt A.
Alt A, lock aspect ratio checkbox not checked. To check, press space
bar.
Alt plus A.
Space to check it.
Space checked.
And now we're going to Shift Tab to our width. We know the height and width are the same, so it doesn't matter which we adjust.
Width colon edit, height colon edit combo 78%. Rotation colon edit.
We do not want to adjust the percentages. Those are too difficult to deal with.
Absolute width edit combo 6.5 quote to set the value. Use the arrow keys or type the value.
Okay, absolute width is 6.5. Let's do 2.5 instead.
2.5.
And let's Shift Tab to make sure that our height adjusted with it.
Absolute radio button. Absolute height edit combo 2.5 quote to set.
Yes, it did. So let's press Enter.
Document 1. Chart line chart description automatically generated graphic chart line chart. Table in line with escape. Document 1. Applications menu cut.
So now that we've changed the size of our picture, I pressed applications again so that we could get here. We need to adjust our alt text. And alt text is important because it allows you to know the content of the graph that you have just inserted. And this is especially important if you have multiple graphs in your document so you can differentiate between them. So we pressed our applications key. So let's press A for edit alt text.
A, leaving menus, document 1-word, alt text, description edit, contains text, type and text.
Okay, and so we've already got a description that was automatically generated. You may have heard it say chart, line chart. So let's do a control A to delete this, or to select all, and then we'll just type right over it.
Selected, chart, comma, line.
Okay, so that's selected. And we're just gonna do
y space equals y space x
caret 2 for x squared. And now we need to do control space and C to close this navigation pane. If you don't close this pane now, then you'll have issues adding alt text to other graphs later. So it's pretty important that you go ahead and do this now. So control space.
Control space menu C. Move to move C. Leaving menus, document 1, page 1, page 1, content edit, y equals x caret 2 graphic, y equals x caret 2 image.
All right, so you heard it say y equals x caret 2 graphic. So our alt text has successfully been added, and we have adjusted the size. So that is how you export a graph from Desmos and insert it into Word.
Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand. To stay up to date on upcoming webinars and training events, complete the sign-up form at freedomscientific.com/webinars. Thanks again for connecting with us.